Hello everybody, welcome back. We're going to be going through this again. We are playing Kagiuchi. Kagiuchu. Yeah, we're playing somebody. And we're going to keep this hand. So let's see what's going on here. Reason we're keeping it, we have an interaction on one and two. We have a second creature. He's got a Deathrite Shaman, which I haven't quite decided if I'm going to swords that yet. I mean, it makes the Gwyph worse, but at the same, we should probably do that. Might as well get it out of the way now. Makes the Gwyph worse, makes the knight worse. At least the Gwyph will be a 2-3 when he goes into play. Unless he plays something that makes me think he might be red. I don't think he's red. So. Ooh, mono black, that could be entertaining. Well, why would he? Okay, so whatever, him. Maybe he's just, yeah, he's probably us. And by us, I mean this. Let's see what's going on here. Oh God, that's annoying. Why did you have to be in my hand? All right, so what are we looking for? Looking for a way to beat this quickly. Abrupt Decay, or I guess Scavenging Ooze will work. Would have been better if you were in my deck. So we're in an interesting situation. This is an issue card. Yep. We're gonna get rid of that one. Hopefully he does not have anything interesting to play and is forced to deal with this Knight of the Reliquary. Again, this is all hoping. I am going to go ahead and get the Bayou at this point and take the damage from this. I mean, I have to fetch anyway, and if I want to be able to swords, then I have to do that. He could have any removal at this point. Like, now he's got this fetch land, so if these are swords in hand, then they're active now. But my hope is that he'll kill his Liliana and not have another one. Unfortunate. There was something to holding that land, but, I mean, there's only so much that we can actually do. Any of the pulse. Alright, so let's just it's not technically done yet. Let's actually fetch out the lands now. Give me Scrub. Stoneforge Mystic is a card. Unfortunately, you know, he is at 3 there. And I am going to go get the Batterskull. I understand that I could have gotten the Jit and played the Jit and blah, 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 blah. But, I mean, there is really only so much that we can do, and it forces him to keep this low. So he's actually playing Nick Fick, a.k.a. The Rock. This is not exactly the best thing for us to be up against. Well, why not? Bob be Bob. He's got way more land. The Shaman I'm not caring too much about right now. I'm actually really happy that I sorted the Shaman before. Yeah, go for it, buddy. And a Goyf. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Yeah, that can go ahead and go. And he did not use his Liliana. Let's see. We still have our Shaman. How big is that Goyf? A 4-5. Our Goyf is in the yard. So we have Shaman, Pride Mage, and that's it at this cost. But we are going to go ahead and do it. No point in not doing it. And let's do that. Like, I don't think we're winning this game. Just, excuse me. FYI. question is, how are we going to do it next turn? I mean, is he really trying this out in place of Veteran Explorer? I mean, kudos to him for having that. Sinkhole. Okay, so no, he's... Yeah, I'm... Deal. We can get rid of that. I'm trying to think. Like, is he just black-green? Is he like an Ava Green that's subbing these in for the Dark Rituals? That's what it looks like. I mean, granted, he's drawn a lot of land to be Ava Green, but... I mean, from the looks of his deck, yeah. I mean, Bob's in place of Tombstalkers. Outside of that, we're seeing everything that's there. Yeah. I honestly just want to see more of his deck, and that's the main reason we're continuing to go here. Find anything in the tournament practice room, I'm going to go ahead and take this. I've already got the 5 out of my deck. So the most it can go down to from this upkeep is 6. Oh, would you look at that? Oh, wait, I can't do it. Guess why? Because if I activate this, he activates his. So. Yeah. Alright, let's think here. How are we going to do this? There are no artifacts in the yard, so when I pitch to Liliana, I am going to get rid of the diamond, but I have to swords the Goyf before I pitch. Yeah, he realized. Bob shows another Bob. So we actually do have the mana to play the Liliana, but we need to get rid of this. We did have the mana to play to pay for the Liliana, but we needed to get rid of that. I'm going to eat one of his lands in his graveyard. That'll force him to eat the same land. Otherwise, I get the mana. It should also tap this. Otherwise, I mean, I guess he gets to force us to sacrifice Bob if he has another Liliana now due to the Bob. Well, take that back. We know what he has in hand. He has another Bob. So, yeah, we're in an interesting situation here. We'll see what he does. I mean, if I were him, I would just let it go. I mean, you can start attacking with your Bob, which means I have more lethal draws. And, oh, he gave it to me. I'm going to take the white. Yep, here comes his Bob. We'll just take care of that problem. Alright, so cards are dealt. Do what you will. Each player discards a card. Okay. Alright, let's see. So, what do we need? He gets in... We take 2 at our end step. So we have to block here. Okay. What do we need? We needed more than that. We'd have needed 2 cards. Like, I can play this, it'll blow that up. We take 2, he swings in for 2, and we take 2 more, and that's that. So, let's keep going. Green-black, just a straight green-black. Alright. Let's see. And for his build, I think I just want to kill stuff. A little bit of life gain. Wait, I remember this process. I wasn't born yesterday. Alright, so you know how they tell you never bring in cards like this against decks like this because you know you may take one card, but there's only so, or but they've got all these other ones. In this style deck, there literally are just confidants, goyfs, and typically at card X, which in this case looks to be shaman as win conditions. So one of these takes out a third of the possible win conditions. Oops, that is not exactly a terrible thing. You're welcome. So, I mean, the options are there. Batterskull's still good, but I don't think I want it. I know I don't want at least this. It's not worth it. He did see a diamond, but I highly doubt he's got deed just due to the converted mana cost of his stuff. I'm gonna do that. Take out one of these. Like, I was thinking about this, but it just doesn't seem like it would be truthfully worth it. Let me see. We want both of those. We want all three of those. I did get the third Abrupt Decay already, borrowing it from a buddy, but I haven't had a chance to put it in. I think that this will just be fine. Oh, almost took that out. So let's drop this. We are getting rid of the Jit. That'll make things a little interesting. Oh, almost did that. Yeah, surprise. Ugh. Would you like to mulligan? Yes, I'd like to mulligan. This hand I will keep, however. So we're gonna go get black white, play shaman. I love hybrid cards. Yeah, if you didn't notice, that's a hybrid card. The next turn we will Thoughtseize Bob. Unless we need to pulse something, which I highly doubt. Scrubland. Cast for black. Pass a turn. Good news, he did go to six as well. So we're not completely out of this. Hopefully this isn't discard. His own shaman. Okay. And we get a diamond. Alright, so I want to go ahead and see what's in his hand then. That is very bad for us. Well, we're going to take that one. And get the land out of the yard. So he can't necessarily do the trick yet. He'll have to decay, otherwise, we get to two him. And then we can go from there. Interesting. I guess he didn't want to get buried in card advantage, but we can at least now get rid of that. We'll take two damage in the process, but at least it's gone. So, black. Oh, wait, he did decay. Cancel. All right. Now the fun part begins. So if he goes to two us here, we go ahead and let it happen. Okay, he didn't. We do have the pulse in our hand. We do. Okay, so he didn't do that. So our end of turn. Okay, we don't have the pulse in our hand. But I am going to start going for his cards. And the. Well, I guess there really is no point. I mean, thanks to his card over there, we're in a situation. Let's go ahead and just I'll let that go. Maybe I can get some more discard out of him with it. Who knows? If he goes to two us again, we'll go ahead and do that. Jeez, I feel like this is the Goyf War all over. There's a Bayou. So, yeah, he is just black green. Second Shaman. A little annoying, but not unbeatable. Gonna go ahead and fetch. He's got the lands already, so no point in trying to tinker around with that. And now we can decay this. If he goes for something, we'll eat it in response. Unless it's land, then we'll let that happen. I mean, he's only got the dark blast. What's he gonna do? Give this guy -1/-1. And then we'll go to eat either the abrupt decay or the him. Probably the abrupt decay. I mean, if he's got witness, I don't care if he hims me again. I have no cards in hand, so it's not that big of a deal. There may have been something to saving this, but I don't feel like having to deal with this situation. Like, not only could they sit there and attack in, but it would just be annoying. All right, so we're gonna get rid of the abrupt decay. We're gonna swords this one. And I'm gonna keep this process going of just eating his stuff on his end step. If I do it during before his draw step, then what ends up happening is he'll shoot the shaman, dredge it back for his draw step, shoot the shaman. All right, we're gonna put a stop to this. Yep. Okay, so he realized, what were we drawing next turn? Pride Mage. Okay, so we were a couple turns away from actually just taking this game away. Pride Mage is not a take the game away, it's just a kind of exist. Let's see. This actually seems a bit better. I didn't take into consideration that his deck is all X2s and X1s, so any hit kills something. Love when you start thinking of the Sesame Street music. I'm going to go down to two of these. So we have first turn Bob. Oh, we're not going to mulligan this hand. Oh, yeah, I don't need this anymore. We had first turn Bob. How do we want to do this? Well, this can be a Savannah at this point. I haven't seen a wasteland out of him, which is awkward, and this will make it a all lands in my deck. Which basically means I'll have two diamonds out of two cards, which is amazingly good. If he's got removal for this, he'll leave it. If he didn't have removal for it, that looks pretty good now. And I'm just gonna pass the turn. Yeah, I mean, if he plays Shaman, he plays Shaman. Whatever. There's a duress. That'll take care of one of these two. Why on earth would he? Yeah. We'll find another one. We won't be playing this guy again. So I will see you all in a little bit.